Well, DB Corp is the first company on our radar. Remember, they had a good third quarter. Earnings came in above estimates. The profit before tax, in fact, grew much higher. The digital business, smaller part of the business, it turned a bit of positive on the back of renewed focus on the business profitability. We have Mr. Girish Agarwal, the promoter director of the company, who joins us. Hi, Mr. Agarwal. Thanks so much for joining in. Well, your print ad revenue, that came in higher by close to around 11.5%, which is quite impressive. It had a couple of tailwinds as well. It was a festive season. We also had elections that took place in the past quarter. What's the outlook, if you could tell us, on this particular business vertical, the print ad revenues going ahead?
So as you see, the overall ad revenue growth is 13% in this quarter. And out of that, let me clarify, the tailwind, what we got from election was only 2%.
Okay.
Because what happened, the routine advertising of government goes down because of the code of conduct. So the net effect of the election is 2% overall growth.
Okay.
So balance, whatever growth has come from festival and the regular business.
Okay, all right. Okay. Mr. Agarwal, we'll just come back to you, sir. We'll just cut in a bit. United Spirits, the con call is right now. We'll get back to chatting with the management of DB Corp. For the time being, let's hop across and hear out what the management of United Spirits is saying.
92% in the third quarter, and that brings the net sales growth of Popular to 2% for the first 9 months of the year. During the quarter, we have managed to maintain our gross margin at 47.3%, which is flat versus the last year, despite adverse input costs and despite the abating flow of the effects of certain price increases from the previous year. For the first 9 months of the fiscal, our gross margin stands at 48.5%, an underlying improvement of 113 bps, primarily achieved through our productivity program and mix that enabled us more than offset the adverse impact of inflation. We have continued to accelerate investment behind our brand. This quarter, our marketing investment grew by 3% versus the last year, despite a higher base. The A&P reinvestment rate for the quarter was 10.7%, in line with the seasonality of our business. Despite flat gross margins versus last year, a relentless focus on bringing down our operating costs has helped us to deliver an underlying EBITDA margin improvement of 91 bps during this quarter. The EBITDA margin was 13.9% and 14.4% for the first 9 months of the year. While we reassert that our medium-term ambition is to deliver EBITDA margin in the mid to high teens on a consistent basis, this progress again gives us confidence that we are making the right steps towards our ambition. We continue to deliver financing cost efficiencies and repay our debt. Interest cost for the quarter was down 16%, despite an environment in which interest costs are tightening. Profit after tax for the quarter was 192 crores, up 43%. Mainly as a result of improved operating performance combined with monetization of some of our non-core assets as well as lower interest costs. I'm pleased to share that during the quarter, we have successfully monetized one of our key properties, that is UB Tower in Bangalore, from our portfolio of non-core assets. Additionally, during the quarter, we have made further progress towards simplification and structural rationalization of our business by disinvesting our stake in 100% subsidiary Four Seasons Wines Limited. The FSWL wine business was a niche and a small part of the overall Diageo portfolio, and this sale will further enable us to focus on growing our core spirits business in India. While we have been in a relatively stable operating environment this year, looking ahead, we do expect the upcoming general elections to have an impact on our sales during the next quarter. Additionally, the input cost environment, after a couple of years of remaining benign, has continued to see a bit of upward pressure. Having said that, these risks are near-term, and the long-term opportunity of the spirits market in India remains intact, and we will continue to execute against our strategy to capture that opportunity. And therefore, I would like to reiterate our medium-term ambition to grow the top line by double digit and improve EBITDA margin to mid to high teens on a consistent basis. With those opening remarks, I'm going to open up the floor for questions.
Thank you very much, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, we will now begin the question and answer session. Anyone who wishes to ask a question may please press star, then one on their touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star, then two. Participants are requested to use handsets while asking a question. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. To ask a question, please press star, then one. The first question is from the line of Avi Mehta from India Infoline. Please go ahead.
Hi, sir. Thanks a lot for this opportunity. Just wanted to understand, follow up on this Maharashtra. There was a news.
Okay, some important statements coming in from United Spirits where the management is a bit cautious in the near term. He said that he expects the election to have an impact in the near term sales, and also the input cost environment, which was benign for the last few years, has now is putting some upward pressure. That's the word that he used. So first, elections will have some impact in the sales in the near term, and even the input cost environment is putting some upward pressure. So those are some statements coming in on United Spirits about the near term. Just adding a line of caution, though they're confident about their medium-term aspiration of a double-digit growth in the top line and margins in the mid to high teens, margins in mid to high teens on a consistent basis. You just keep watching the flashes and ticker line. Our team is listening in to the conference call, and they will keep putting those updates on your screen. In the meanwhile, let's continue our conversation with the management of DB Corp. We are in conversation with Girish Agarwal, the promoter director. Girish, you spoke about a 13% print ad revenue growth with a tailwind of only 2% on account of the elections. What about in the radio business? That has done exceedingly well. What was the growth in the ad revenue over there and the guidance in the coming quarter, considering it's the election season?
So radio again has grown by 39%, and over there the EBITDA margin has gone double, almost to 43% now. And over there also the election impact is only 7%. So if I remove that 7% out of that 39%, so radio still has 32% growth, which is because of the festive and the overall growth in the market.
Okay, all right. Girish, coming back to your print ad revenue there as well, you said 11%. Out of that, 2% was because of elections. But net, it's still a good performance. 9% growth is what you have delivered. What kind of a number should we work with going ahead? High single digits or a double digit number? And also, I want to focus on the margins, because apparently newsprint prices have corrected by more than 10% from the peak. Does that help your margins for the coming quarters?
True. So let me explain you first about the advertising future growth. See, this growth largely has come because of the categories like automobile, education and real estate. And we believe that these are the categories which may continue to grow. So in future also, we can expect the similar kind of growth coming in unless until something very positive or something very negative happens. In fact, we see positive happening in the months to come because of general election also happening in the month of May. So that will be another advantage. And on the margin side, this time we are at 20%, 21% EBITDA margin, which is flat in spite of the newsprint prices being very high. If you remember, the newsprint prices used to be around $480, which went up to as high as $750. Now they have started coming down. They have come down to around $575, so around 23% correction. But this correction will be seen actually in the next year, because in this year, this month and the next quarter, what we are buying is already deals already happened. So the deliveries are happening now. So the reduced price benefit will happen in the Q1 and Q2 of the next year.
Girish, you said there was a 2 percentage point benefit on account of elections in your print business and about 7% in your radio business. How is Q4 shaping up for you?
Yep.
What should we expect?
So as I mentioned to you, the election will have some positive impact because general election coming up.
Yeah.
At the same time, real estate, automobile, if these categories continue to grow, so we are very hopeful that, to maintain a high single digit or double digit should be possible.
Okay, Girish, very quickly, your digital revenues, they came in only at around 14 crores odd, though it turned a bit positive. What's the outlook out there? What's the contribution that's likely to come in there?
So in the we have around 20% EBITDA margin in the digital business now, and we are very confident that we will be able to grow the margin over there further going forward.
Okay, we'll leave it at that. Thank you very much, Girish, for joining in. So that's the word
coming
in from DB Corp.